Hey everybody, welcome to the adventures of the Oklahoma Grunt Man. Hope you're having a wonderful, wonderful Wednesday. It's a beautiful day here in Southwest Missouri. I'm just going to take you guys around here a little bit through the town of Hermitage, Missouri. I'll turn it around here. I'll take you on a little tour of Hermitage. It's not much. It's not a very big town. But we'll take you around here. Over here to my right is where Cindy works at the Community Health Center here. In fact, this is her vehicle, this Toyota right in front. This is our sheriff's office right here. I haven't been here to Hermitage for quite a while. We'll take you down through around the square. This is the courthouse over here, the Hickory County Courthouse. This is Main Street, or it's called the Square here. It's all the business district downtown here. I say it's not a real big town, but it's pretty nice little town here in Missouri. Everybody's pretty friendly. But I was just sitting here at Casey's. I downloaded some video from the GoPro. Took me a little while. And I actually accidentally deleted some of my video from this morning, but that's all right. I can always film more video. But yeah, we'll take you down through here. Like I say, there's not a whole lot here. I'm guessing Hermitage is a town of 400-500 people. It's kind of spread out a little bit. They got one supermarket, a couple banks. This is Oak Star Bank here. The supermarket's up here on my left. It's called Five Star Supermarket. There used to be a thrift store up here, but I think it went out of business. This is a little bit of residential up in here. Everything is built around the lake. I think tomorrow we'll go over to the lake and we'll go over to the dam. Show you guys some of around the lake there. Community centers right here off to my left. They got a brand new Dollar General here. We'll turn around here. There's a lot of Dollar Generals here. We'll just turn around here. Like I say, there's not much more. Here, you'll go out of town if I keep going. But here in Missouri, we have a lot of Dollar Generals. here in Hickory County, there's a lot of Dollar Generals. But this is Highway 54 in Hermitage, Minnesota. Blooper, Missouri. There is a flea market right back there. We might turn around and go to that. Give me some more video to share with you guys, and we'll see if we can find any bargains in there. And I believe this is Senior Apartments here. Hickory Estates, it's called. But yeah, we'll run up here to this flea market once and see if we can find any bargains. It's called Beyond Bargains Flea Market. So we'll go check it out and see if we got any Beyond Bargains that we can deal with. So we'll pick it up when we get inside. Definitely have a lot of stuff in here. I definitely don't see nothing I can't live without yet, but it's early. There's a lot of stuff. A lot of Hot Wheels. That trash basket's pretty cool. A little bit of fishing stuff. Joiner, $400. That's not a very good bargain. video games. Or these are movies, actually, I guess. Some old cameras. Lots of DVDs, but not many games. Thank you. Old milk jugs, that's pretty cool. But so far, I haven't seen anything I can't live without. Hey everybody, I didn't find anything that I needed in the thrift store there, but it was kind of neat to stop in there and check it out. Right now I think I'm going to run back to Wes's house and maybe do a load of laundry quick. So I get that done. And then tomorrow when it's nicer out, I can spend more time out and about. So we're going to work our way back to Wes's. This video will probably be a two-day video. I don't have a whole lot today yet. Like I said, I went over to the old cafe where I used to cook at and visited over there a little bit. And hope you guys enjoyed the little trip around Hermitage here. Like I say, it's not very big, but yeah, this is where I used to live after I left Iowa. Well, I actually didn't live here. I lived pretty much up there where the gun shop was at, where Wes's shop, just down the road and across the highway a little bit. Maybe tomorrow I'll run over there and show you that too. I've done it before, but maybe I'll do that again tomorrow also. Show you where I used to live. And we might run to Bolivar tomorrow just for the heck of it. I know Selena would probably enjoy seeing more around Bolivar there. I've only showed you just the highway going through. I've never taken you around Bolivar. So yeah, we might do that tomorrow. And take you to the dam. I'll get started earlier in the morning tomorrow. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this little tour, and we'll get definitely more stuff tomorrow. So God bless you guys, and we'll talk to you later. Hey everybody, it's Thursday morning. Supposed to be in the 60s today. Hope you're having a wonderful Thursday. There's a couple days worth of videos that will be in with this video here. I did get some video yesterday, and I'm actually on my way over to Bolivar, Missouri right now. We're going to get some video over there. Hope you guys enjoy that. I've never really got you guys much video from Bolivar, just going through as I come in. But yeah, we're going to go check out Bolivar. I'll show you some of the highlights of it. And then when I get back, I'll get some of the lake, drive around the lake a little bit and show you what's going on there. But yeah, we're just going to go enjoy the day. It's supposed to be up in the mid-60s today, so it's going to be a pretty nice day out. It started off kind of chilly. It was down to 32 last night. But the 60s today, 70s tomorrow, and 70s on Saturday when I go back to Oklahoma. So yeah, just going to get my video started here for the Thursday, and we'll get you a video uploaded again today somewhere. I might actually do it while I'm over here at Bolivar, and then the lake, if I go to the lake today, it'll be on tomorrow's video. We'll just have to see what I all get over here at Bolivar. But anyway, I just wanted to get my video started. God bless you guys. I love you, and we'll talk to you when we get into Bolivar. Hey everybody, we're just about coming into Bolivar here. Yeah, just wanted to get you guys a little video actually coming into Bolivar. Not sure what we're gonna stop in and see here. I want to go to probably go to Walmart for sure while I'm over here, and maybe to Dollar Tree, check out their Dollar Tree here in Missouri. But we'll definitely drive around and show you some of the sights of Bolivar. Not sure what the population is. It's not real big, but it's not real small either. I'm guessing it's, I can't really tell you, I guess. If I had to guess, I'd say it's somewhere about the same size as Woodward. Maybe 11 or 12,000 people, but I could be wrong. I'll have to look it up and see, and I'll put it in the description. But it is a pretty good size town here. The CMH Medical is real big over here, all the way through the Ozarks here. The school's coming up here on the my right. $10,325, the sign said, coming into Bolivar, so I didn't miss it too far. But this is the school here, off to my right. And I think this might be either the elementary or middle school, I'm not sure. The name of their sports teams are the Liberators. The Bolivar Liberators. Looks like they're looking for bus drivers. They had a sign on the fence. Oh, I wanted to hire bus drivers. But if I go to my left, I go halfway. Halfway Missouri. We're halfway to nowhere. So, I've always got a kick out of that. Yeah, let's go to halfway. Halfway to where? But yeah, we're coming in on the east side, northeast side of Bolivar right here. Got a Dollar General here that's new since I've lived here. Off to my left there is a Dollar General. That's new since I've lived here. It looks like they're building something else right here. They're just starting the dirt work. Don't know what it's going to be. This is kind of residential leading up into the business district. I was in the hospital here in Bolivar quite a few years ago, I guess it was. I had a real bad asthma attack. I spent 3 days in the hospital here. Looks like they're putting some sheetrock in the building up here. It must be remodeling the apartments or something up there. They got sheetrock up there on the crane, hauling it into the building there. Looks like a lot of sheetrock too. But this is business district right down through here. This is Highway 32 we're on. I'm sure Selena knows this very well, because she, as you guys know, she used to live here in Bolivar and had a business here. Rooster's Barbecue. Car lot. It's an Asian fusion restaurant. And here's the walk bridge. Coca-Cola Bottling Company. Slumber. through. But yeah, if I keep going straight here, I go over Highway 13. I don't know how long this Casey's has been here. I don't ever remember it being here. Well, gas is only $3.09 here. I might just fill up gas while I'm here. Because I think I got an upside app that I can actually save some money. So I think we're going to top off with gas here. Maybe get something to drink. So we'll pick this back up after I get done getting some gas. We'll talk to you in a little bit. Hey everybody, okay, we're back headed back into Bolivar. We'll swing through this water park up here and show you a little bit more of that when we get up here. Like I say, I've never been to it, but it's an all indoor water park. Swing through there and show you. A little bit of it. It's got indoor pool, everything there. I've never really been in here, so there's a senior health center across the street. Like I say, I'm not sure what all this is. Looks like we got a little park here. Like this is all undeveloped out here. I don't know if this looks like the golf course off here to my left. Right here, this looks like part of the golf course. Yeah, here's one of the greens right here. But yeah, I've never been to this I don't know if this is owned by the city or if it's a private business. I'm not real positive. It almost looked like a city public swimming area. This lady here didn't even look. She just backed out. Didn't care that I was here. Yeah, they got a lot of different water slides and pools and all kinds of stuff in there. It's pretty cool. It even goes clear out to the outside here, that tube. Like I say, it's been here for a while. I remember seeing it here, but I've never been to it, so I can't tell you. Looks like there's people in the pool. So yeah, that's a little bit of that. The library is right here. See if we can find the hospital and I'll take you by there. Like I say, I spent 3 days in the hospital here when I had my asthma attack. And they treated me wonderful. I will say it was a good hospital. Calvary Baptist Church. I just got to remember how to get to the hospital. It's been so long since I've been there. I know it's over on this side of town somewhere, but we're down right in the residential area here now. I've never really traveled a lot of Bolivar here other than on the main roads. I've never really been down here much in the residential part of town. I never really knew anybody over here. Bolivar that I ever had to come and visit. Like I say, I never visited the residential part. My friend Cheyenne lives over here somewhere in Bolivar, Mary's daughter. I'm not sure where she lives at. Cemetery right here in the middle of town. It looks like an old cemetery. Church here on the corner. It's pretty cool. of me coming up here. The ambulance is out here. Lady in my prayers today. The ambulance is picking her up. It looked like an elderly lady with a walker. Looked like they were gonna assist her. Hopefully it was nothing too severe. Hospital's up here on my left, the Life Flight helicopter. I'll swing through the parking lot here. And Citizens Memorial Hospital. Yeah, I spent 3 days here in the hospital. And like I say, they treated me wonderful. The first night I was in intensive care because they couldn't get my oxygen level to come up. And I had a male nurse, and he was just super wonderful. He was there every hour checking up on me and asking me if I needed anything. He was just super, super wonderful. All the nurses there, even the next day, when I finally got out of intensive care and put into a room, they were all super wonderful. The doctors, I didn't really see that much, other than the first night when I was in the ER. At first I went to the walk-in clinic because I couldn't breathe. I was having an asthma attack. And they couldn't do anything for me at the clinic, so they called an ambulance, and I went by ambulance to the hospital here, to the ER. And I was in the ER for probably 5 or 6 hours. And then they got me into the intensive care, and I spent the whole night in there. But yeah, they treated me good and got me all fixed up. So that's the tour of the hospital. And this is their Life Flight helicopter right here. Okay, we're getting back down close to the business district here in Bolivar. There is a Baptist church here in Bolivar is huge. There's actually a Baptist Bible College out here. We'll go by here in a little bit. Just about down to the square. In the business district. This is the courthouse over here. They got a beautiful, beautiful courthouse here in Bolivar. Yeah, the courthouse is just gorgeous. And then these are some of the businesses. This the back side of the courthouse. Peddler's Post is over here. It's a thrift store. It's kind of congested here the way the streets run, but I mean, it's not bad. It's just, you gotta be on your toes, but Bolivar's in Polk County, so we're actually in Polk County now, not Hickory County. There's a Sonic over here on the left. But they got pretty much everything that Woodward has. They got McDonald's, Sonic. They even got a Scooter's Coffee up here. Not Starbucks, Tristan. It's Scooter's. Domino's Pizza. We don't even have a Domino's in Woodward. They got a Grease Monkey Garage just like we do in Woodward. There's Woods Supermarket. We might stop in there on the way back too. I'm not sure yet. McDonald's. This is the main strip going out north and south of Foodtown. O'Reilly's Auto Parts. Here's Tristan's place. He would like to eat Master Wong's. They do have, I've had their cashew chicken in there before. It was pretty good. Off to my right here, Southwest Electric, and then this other building. This is the Bible College I was telling you about. It's a Baptist Bible College. Assembly of God Church. Yeah, Southwest Baptist University. Theater is over here to my left in this little mall area over here. There's Maurice's. I'm not sure what else. There used to be a pawn shop in there. Verizon Wireless is up here. And Walgreens is over to my left. Shop still there. Taco Bell. Got a Pizza Hut. Hopefully it's better than our Pizza Hut in Woodward. And Arby's, of course. So yeah, it's got pretty much the same stuff as Woodward. There's another Dollar Tree. So yeah, they got three Dollar Trees here in Bolivar. Here's Dollar General there. Here's Dollar Tree up here. Subway. T-Mobile. And then of course you got Walmart here. I really don't need anything here at Walmart, but we might stop in and check it out.
Missouri 8 Freeway to Missouri 13 plus Bolivar. Springfield Avenue. highway street for 3/4 of a mile. Turn right onto East Broadway Street. Head south on South Benton Avenue toward East Jackson Street, then turn left onto East Jackson Street.
Chops. I'm going to do some baked pork chops, some potato wedges, and baked beans for dinner tonight. That way they don't have to come home and cook. So I'm going to surprise them with that. They'll have come home and dinner will be ready for them, or pretty much ready. So we're going to go do that. Now I'm going to run over to Dollar Tree and check out the Dollar Tree once. And then we'll head back toward Nemo, Pittsburgh, Hermitage. Oh, it's all the same area. But Selena, I hope you enjoyed this little tour around Bolivar. I'm sure I could have went and seen more yet. Looks like the Life Flight helicopter just took off. It's flying up ahead of me there. I'm sure you can't see it. It's quite a ways up there. But yeah, I hope you guys like this little tour of Bolivar. I'm probably going to get my video uploaded here before I head out. Because I got real good service over here, and it'll just be faster. The Dollar Tree is right pretty much over here across the street from Walmart. So we're going to head in there and check it out. And we'll bring you along with that. Actually, when I said I went into the hospital at the time of the asthma attack, this is the walk-in clinic right here that I went to, and I wasn't real impressed with that. I was having an asthma attack and I couldn't breathe, and well, they wanted to do x-rays, and the x-ray technician goes, "Well, hold your breath so when I take the x-ray, as long as you can." And I go, "Lady, if I had any breath to hold, I would hold it." And then after that, the doctor come in and they give me a breathing treatment, and it didn't even make any effect. And he goes, "Well, I might have to do a tracheotomy." And I go, "I don't have an obstruction. I just can't breathe." I said, "I don't need a tracheotomy for asthma attack." And then he goes, "Maybe we'll just call an ambulance and get you to the hospital." I said, "There you go." But I couldn't believe he wanted to do a tracheotomy cut a hole in my throat because I couldn't breathe. But anyway, I'm going to run in here to Dollar Tree and we'll check this out and we'll bring you along. Talk to you later. God bless. Hey everybody, just walking up here to Dollar Tree. Hey Tristan, they got a China King here too. Tristan enjoys the Chinese food. Thank you, sir. A lot of Easter stuff right now. And graduation. But it's pretty much the same as our Dollar Tree in Woodward. They pretty much got the same stuff. They do have a frozen section like our new one. Pretty much the same thing. there, I think I'm pretty much ready. I don't see anything else I can't live without that I can't get back in Woodward. They pretty much got the same stuff. Hey everybody, hope you had a wonderful Thursday. I'm just gonna get my video finished up here before I head out of Bolivar. I stopped and got a bottle of water for on the way home. Just hope you guys enjoyed this little video here in Bolivar today. Wanted to get you guys something different. At least the weather's finally starting to warm up. Mary and I wanted to take you around to some of the lakes earlier on Tuesday when I spent the day with her, but it was just way too cold. It only got up to 35 degrees, so yeah, that didn't work out, but we still had a good time. Thank you, Mary, for hanging out with me for the day. I definitely had a lot of fun with it. Tomorrow, the kids and the grandkids are coming over. We're going to have dinner together tomorrow night at Wes and Cindy's and hang out in the evening before I head back on Saturday morning. But yeah, just going to get my video uploaded here. Like I always say, treat everybody the way you want to be treated. Make this world a better place. Keep moving toward them goals one step at a time. Be nice. Be kind. Just be a good person. Keep the Lord in your heart if you can. It's my niece Kayla's birthday today. Wish her a happy birthday. And she's going through some rough times right now, so if you can keep her in your prayers. I don't want to get into the personal part of it, but she can definitely use your prayers and thoughts as she goes through this difficult time she's in right now. Just say a special prayer for her if you would. Definitely appreciate it. God bless each and every one of you. I love you. And we'll talk to you tomorrow.